Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about GFO in a freshwater aquarium. Right here I have about a 10 gallon beaker, and it's definitely not a fish tank. You can see that I actually got it from a science laboratory a few years ago, and it's just glass. And you can see that it's marked all over the place how many liters it is. It's really cool, but I got it for free, and of course it's me, so I had to make it a fish tank. But right over here, of course, there's a really messy office, but we have windows coming in and a very, very bright bulb. Don't know why it's such a bright bulb, except it's the only one we had hanging around. And we have two very large, I don't even know what you want to call them, just sailfin mollies. And they're directly from Mexico. I ordered them, and they're doing really good in here. You can see the female's a nice good orange, and she's quite pregnant, and the male, I scared him really bad right there. He has really good pearlescence in his tail. It's not showing up on the camera at all. But a few days ago, we completely lost visibility in the tank from green water, and there's still some algae on the glass, but we had to scrape that off. But what I did was I added a little bag of GFO. You can barely see it hanging on the back there. And what GFO does is it removes phosphorus, and you probably all know that, but it's just ferric oxide, and you know, through chemical processes it takes it out. I don't even know how it works, except I know it's working well because this tank is almost clear of green water. I'm very happy. And I've never heard of anybody using it in freshwater. I always hear about reef aquarists do it, so I just want to let you guys know that it's working very well in my little freshwater tank.